Welcome back to RJK English. This is my most ill-fated of sessions. I've done this multiple times and something's gone wrong every time. But we're going to try it here. I want to look at Kashmiri music, and I want to focus on how different it is. I'm going to show some Hindustani music that you might be familiar with, or it might sound familiar, and then I'm going to switch to Kashmiri. And we're just going to see how different it is, okay? So let me actually make sure that everything's going because I feel like I'm unlucky right now. All right, so here we are. Beautiful song by Arijit Singh. Sounds hopefully sounds somewhat familiar to you, like you've heard something like this. Really nice chord change here. I'll have all of these linked in the description. So maybe you've heard this song. If you've seen the movie Inside Man, they play this at the end, Spike Lee movie. This is A.R. Rahman, who's an amazing composer and singer. That's Shah Rukh Khan, an actor. Here's a song you might have heard from Slumdog Millionaire. Everybody thought they knew about India after this. So that one's made for American audiences, you know, so it's kind of a dance number. Now let's switch to Hindustani classical. I don't think this will sound too strange to you. Okay, different from here if you're from the West, but still accessible. We've heard this before. What about this? I'm guessing this sounds like, you know, you've at least heard this when you've gone to yoga or gotten a massage or gone to an Indian restaurant. You've heard something like this, right? Now getting into the folk realm. Here's Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan. This is Qawwali. That's Rahat Fateh Ali Khan. He's a very famous singer now. It's Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan's nephew. So this is Sufi music, but it's more folk style. People are, you know, you'll hear the crowd go crazy over it. Now let's hear some actual folk singers. This lady has an amazing voice. Again, all of these are in the description for you to peruse, but let's listen to this guy's voice. Look at him. He's the coolest looking guy. But he is a folk singer, okay? And he's singing religious music to God, to Allah, to God, but also stories, things like this, but that is a folk style. Oh, goes a little out of what we would usually do in Western music, but it's still Western notes. Here's a Bengali folk singer. And here's some really nice folk music. So I have all of these linked, but I want to show that to show how different it is when we switch to Kashmiri. So here's first Ali Safuddin, very talented young singer. His guitar sounds a little off, but wait till his voice comes in. This is a Dal Lake scene, typical way that an older woman would look in Kashmir. Lower register than I'd usually hear in Hindustani music. You'll hear that myan that we're learning in Kashmiri. Very heartfelt and passionate. Yeah. Modern. It reminds me of Bono in U2, the Unforgettable Fire. I think it was their third album. Now, let's switch to this. Again, Ali Safuddin, modern. But listen to this instrument right here. That is a rabab, Kashmiri rabab. And that is a very strange chord sequence that I wouldn't usually hear in Hindustani music. Let's get to his singing. I mean, you'll hear the mya that we're learning in Kashmiri language, but it does sound to me quite different. Here's a famous musician. Listen to the difference here. Again, favoring the baritone. He's wearing a faran, which is for cold weather. So again, quite different. Here is a female singer at a wedding. And last one, I think that's right here. So I'll stop there. There's also some others that are, you know, a mixture of Hindustani and Kashmiri music. But I would say that Kashmiri music that I'm hearing, oh, I'm sorry, there's one more that I want to share with you. I apologize. One second. Right here. Where is it? One moment. Here we go. This is what I hear my friend's mom, auntie, my listening to. This is a Sufi peer or holy man. So that, I hope, cinches it that that is quite different from things that you've heard. What it reminds me of is more towards, I'm hitting my background, and more towards Afghanistan, but it sounds like kind of Persian, Turkic. And my point is that Kashmir sounds a lot different from the rest of North India, at least as far as I have heard. And what I did was I even sampled folk music, because Kashmiri music tends to be more towards folk music, as far as I've seen. And even then, it sounds very different. It seems to tend to towards minor key, but also it tends to favor these voices that you usually don't hear. Almost like an operatic, and a cacophony of sounds in the background. Again, Turkic, Persian, and Arab music have different notes than the Western scale. So they have what we call microtones. And Kashmiri music, as far as I've seen, does not have that. It might have it a little bit, but not really. It's still staying within the scale that we're familiar with, but it's arranging it much different. And so my point in this is for us to see that Kashmir is different. And as we approach it, we're going to approach something that maybe we haven't heard before. And we need to keep our ears out for that. But it's good to listen to this too, so that I start to hear the Kashmiri language. So anyways, I hope this is useful to you. I have songs linked in the description, and I will see you next time. Hi everyone, welcome to RJK English. Make sure to like and subscribe, and that will help me make more of these videos. I'm on YouTube and on Instagram, and see us on Facebook and we can talk further.